got baseball for you from Guaranteed Rate Field on the south side of Chicago. Ought to be a good one here between the San Diego Padres and the St. Louis Cardinals.
And now, your 2000
Cardinals baseball is straight ahead.
St. Louis
next on
Cardinals.
The show. And that'll bring up Fernando Tatis Jr. And we are ready for some daytime baseball. From the 1-1 pitch. Altogether a fine afternoon for baseball. 66 degrees the game time temperature. This is foul right side. Another 1-2 delivery. There's a drive out toward the alley in right center. He takes the turn and heads for second. And he will pull into second with a leadoff double.
Got accepted. The third baseman, number 13, Manny Machado.
At the plate, Manny Machado. He's able to ride this one high and deep toward right center. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. He's in at second safely as they jump ahead with a run scoring on the play. And now Jake Cronin. And it's fouled away. Here comes the 1-2. Weak grounder down the line at third. And he'll reach first safely.
That is good. The left fielder, number 5. Will Myers.
So now to the plate, Will Myers. A 1-2 count to Will Myers. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at bat going. The next 1-2 pitch. Runners are at first and third with none out. Tried to get him to chase the curveball away, but it breaks outside. 2-2 now.
After multiple pitches were fouled off, it gets a little disappointing as a pitcher. So you think, say, I'm going to throw one way off the plate and see if he'll chase it. Didn't happen.
Now he gets the ground ball to first. This might be two. The second for one. It's a double play, although the run does come into score from third. So base is empty now after the double play. And set to go is the veteran first baseman, Eric Hosmer. The 1-2 from Wainwright.
At the ball.
Pretty good breaking ball to lay off of right there. If I'm pitching, I might think this guy might be sitting on something off speed.
And he'll find a way to get a piece of that one to stay alive.
Hey, that's a huge double play to settle everybody down right now. Giving up a few early runs. Let's see if he can get out of this inning and regroup.
O'Neill gets under it and makes the catch to end the inning. That brings in Tommy Edmond. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-1 pitch. Left side. And that's a base hit, so the pressure's on to open up the inning. Into the box, Paul Goldschmidt. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Head-to-head numbers with you. He's got 8 hits in 25 tries. He also has 1 home run. 2-1 pitch is a cut fastball taken for strike 2. hit back toward the mound. To second for one. Over to Hosmer. A double play. Two down, no one on base. And next will be Tyler O'Neill. Fouled away. Payoff pitch on its way. And he watches a called third strike on the cut fastball that time, and that will retire the side. Now in the box, Victor Caratini. He'll be in there to start things out against Adam Wainwright.
For me, this is an important add-on inning here. Their little lead, I like it, but keeping the pressure on, building that lead, that's how you bury someone.
On the first, and there's one gone here to start the second. So one down, no one aboard. And that brings up Trent Grisham. 3-2 pitch. And he takes ball four, so he's on. And as you know, that often means the steal could be in order here. So one gone in the inning here with a runner at first. And that brings up Adam Frazier. Throw over to the bag. And a dive, but he's back in there.
That's a ball.
And there's ball two now.
He might still be thrown off from that first inning, guys. He got knocked around pretty good, and that can be hard to recover from mentally sometimes.
Runner goes for second. Swinging a soft liner on to first. So a runner in scoring position with two men gone, and the pitcher bats next. That will be Yu Darvish. Down low, two balls and a strike.
One pitch shy of 40 for him right now, and he's not even out of the second inning of work. He's definitely not being as efficient on the mound as he'd like.
And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Here's Nolan Arenado. Head-to-head numbers with Yu Darvish. He's gone 5-for-13. Two of those hits were for home runs. All even now, 2-2. Now here it comes. Back up the middle and in for a base hit. So the inning's underway with the Cardinals getting their leadoff hitter on base. Into the box now. Yadier Molina fouled off. Now a double play ball here as this is on the ground to third. And he'll reach first as they can't make the play on him. And now here is Dylan Carlson as he'll dig into the left-handed batter's box.
And this isn't his strong side, at least not in terms when you look at the stat sheet or his consistent contact rates. I just don't think he's quite as smooth with his rhythm and swing mechanics when he's hitting left-handed.
Arenado on second, Molina at first with no outs. And he fouls this one off. And that's into the corner, a foul ball and right. He'll try it again, 3-2. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Myers is under it, looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. So now to the plate, Edmundo Sosa.
Not shortstop. Edmundo Sosa.
Now a ball grounded to short. This could be two. To Frazier at the bag. On to Hosmer, but it'll come too late to get them both. So that'll bring in Harrison Bader. Two's all over the place. Two on, two out, and of course, here in inning number two. Now the 2-1. Swung on, and this ball is hammered. Forget about it. And that ball will stay fair, and it's gone. A home run. Blake now. Adam Wainwright hit back up the middle. Throw in time and the side is retired. Set for the start of the inning, and next will be a speed thread in the form of outfielder Fernando Tatis Jr. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes, and he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. And it's fouled away. Curveball, and he buckled him, but it's full 3-2.
That hook stayed up in the zone. You can see he struggled with that curveball early.
Thank you, man.
He's trying to find that release point with his off-speed pitches. Love to see if he can find the feel for that thing moving forward.
Here's Manny Machado now. And he lays off there, ball four. So back-to-back walks have him in business here with nobody out. Striding in is Jake Cronenworth. Base knocked to the outfield could score the tying run from second. Unable to get the bat around in time, and the count evens at 2-2. From the belt, kicks and deals. Drilled on the ground to short. Fielded cleanly. One there. Relay to Goldie, and that gets him as well a double play. So stepping in is Will Myers, trying to bring in the tying run from third here. Swing and a miss. That one tied him up. Tatis at third with two away. Swing and a miss, and that's out number three. Now into the box, Tommy Edman. He'll begin things here against Yu Darvish. And this is taken for a called strike. Oh, that's a tough call. Now 1-2.
I think getting the leadoff man in every inning is important as a pitcher. When you're coming off an inning that you really labored through, it makes all the difference mentally.
So he racks up the swinging strikeout on the breaking ball. Tommy Edman is retired for the first out here in the bottom half of the third. Just hung in there on that one. Two-two, here it is. Not close with that one. It's way above the strike zone.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2. But when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone, it's obviously easy to take that one.
Payoff pitch one more time. And he lets him off the hook there, as this isn't even close for ball four. The next to bat for St. Louis, Tyler O'Neill. He went down looking in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, in today's game, certainly don't get completely reprimanded for too many strikeouts, but no one likes to go down looking. Expect him to be a little bit more aggressive at the dish this AB.
And that's in there, base hit.
Now batting, third baseman, Nolan.
Standing in now, Nolan Arenado. fouled away. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. That's back toward the mound. This will be a tough turn, however. And indeed, he'll not even as he goes to first, and that means two men are in scoring position now with two away. Here's the catcher, Yadier Molina. He's got a chance to add to this early lead as he'll bat with a couple of guys in scoring position. Hard on the ground toward short. Scooped up. On to first, and the Redbird rally goes for naught as that ends the inning. At the plate now is Eric Hosmer, comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. The 1-1 takes a pass and misses. That's strike two. And 2-2.
You know he's probably cheating on that inside pitch after he got jammed earlier. If you're on the mound right now, you want to try to hit that outside corner, and there's a pretty good chance you'll get him to roll over something.
The catcher. Digging in now for San Diego. Victor Caratini. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Hit on the ground to third. Gloved by Arenado. Throw on to first, and Wainwright has it working now. Two away. Next to the plate for the Padres, Trent Grisham worked a walk his first time up. Two runs, three hits, and one error for the Padres so far. Fouled off. And another foul ball. Strike three called, and the inning is over. Now to bat, Dylan Carlson flew out last time up. The 1-1 home. Down the left field line and deep. And that will end up a foul ball. And he fouls this one off. Two and two.
The classic back foot slider right there with two strikes. Usually gets a ton of swing and misses. Nice layoff right there. Fight for another pitch.
Careful. And he missed with this one up around the noggin. Now it's full. Edmundo Sosa will be next. A bouncer up the middle. And there's one away. Stepping in for the Cardinals, Edmundo Sosa reached by way of a fielder's choice his first time around. He's set, and the 2-2 pitch. Skied down the left field line. Myers is going to get there as he backs up to put it away, and there are two gone now. Next, it'll be Harrison Bader, and we'll see what he can do here after going deep his first time up. Off the outside that time as the breaking ball can't catch the zone.
And obviously, this guy's a double threat up there. He can run, and he can go yard, too. You don't want to walk him because he might steal a base on you, but you don't want to groove a fastball either because he could take you out of the yard.
Grisham makes the catch to end the inning. So here's Adam Frazier. He's 0 for 1 thus far. And that misses off the plate and low, so it's 3-1 now.
You can bet they love ball four here. That gives the pitcher on deck an obvious bunt situation to move the runner into scoring position.
And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away. So bases are empty with one gone. And the pitcher bats next. That'll be Yu Darvish. Fifth inning of play here in a 3-2 ball game. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. Sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
In now, Fernando Tatis Jr. And he lays off here. A nice job. It's ball four. First and second now with one away. Sliced hard on the ground. Taken in by Goldschmidt. The second for one. On to Goldschmidt, and it's in time. A double play, and the side is retired. Play at Wainwright as we move past the halfway point in this one and begin the bottom of the fifth. The 1-1 is laid off for ball two. Slider misses and he's in danger of losing him here. 3-1. Can't find the zone either. It's ball four, and on just five pitches, he's walked the pitcher leading off the inning.
Second baseman, Tommy Edman.
He's set, and the 2-1 pitch.
No, that's down.
Got to find a way to get back in his zone. I know you're in danger of losing both to walks, but certainly don't miss over the heart of the plate and have this guy gap one, or even worse, hit a two-run homer.
A swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Right fielder looking up. Gone! Ross Detweiler, a 6'5" left-hander, takes over on the mound now.
Number 35, Ross Detweiler.
Stepping in now, Paul Goldschmidt.
If you're on the mound right here, you got to trust your catcher and execute. You know who's coming up to the plate.
Here now the 2-2. Detweiler has compiled over 600 innings of work in his major league career and has an ERA he'd like to see come down a bit. Starts the day in the high fours. Fly ball to straightaway left. Myers comes in a few steps as he hauls it in for the first. Now to the plate, here is Tyler O'Neill, singled in his last at-bat. And it's fouled away. Three-two pitch. Struck him out, so he's down on strikes for the second time this afternoon. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Nolan Arenado. He's singled in two trips to the plate thus far. The 2-1 pitch.
Ball three.
Yadier Molina would be next if they can keep this inning alive. The 3-1 pitch. And oh, that gets him on the mound. Fortunately, he's able to stick with it and get the out at first, and that'll put an end to the inning. New inning set to get underway, and stepping up as the shortstop, Jake Cronenworth. 1-1. Swing and a liner. Bader patrolling center makes the play, one out. Here's Will Myers, 0-2 for him to this point. 5-2 is our score here in inning number six. Swung on, but it's pulled foul wide of third. Fouled away.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
And this is swung out and missed, so it's two up, two down to start the sixth inning. Next up is Eric Hosmer. Out in his last trip, so looking for better fortunes here.
Yeah, he hit it hard. That's all you can add.
Whoa, hold on. What a stop. He's out. Ready now is Yadier Molina. Lifetime in this matchup. He's 1-for-5. The 2-2. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Grounded back up the middle. Reined in. And that's out number one. Coming in, Dylan Carlson. No hits to this point. The pitch. Line to second, where it's caught there for out number two. Now at the plate here is Edmundo Sosa. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Here comes the 1-2. Little chopper back to the mound. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Digging in will be Victor Caratini. He bounced out last time up.
Yeah, Matty, and it looked like a sinker in his last AB that got him to roll over. Kind of similar situation right here. Similar stuff on the mound. Look for them to try and get him to do exactly the same thing as his last AB. He's got to fight to get it elevated just a little bit more.
Fouled off. Goes after the sinker there as this is fouled away. Boy, good cutting action to that pitch as that's the first out of the inning. Andrew Miller will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Paul DeYoung is into the ball well as he'll slide into the pitcher spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch. The 3-1. And he misses ball four. So he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces. So a runner at first now with one away, and that brings up Adam Frazier. And he'll dive back in safely. The 2-2. Lifted down the line in left. Left fielder giving chase. He gets there and makes the play for the second out of the inning. Austin Nova come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Number 22, Austin Nova.
Here comes the 1-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Austin Adams gets the call from the pen to take the ball for the home seventh. Last half of the seventh here, and at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Harrison Bader. Here comes the 1-2.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal. You can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning. 5-2, our score as we play inning number 7.
DeYoung.
Swing, and there it goes. He got all of that ball. And out of here. And I mean by plenty. That ball was crushed. At the plate, Tommy Edman. 2-1. 6 runs, 6 hits, and no errors so far for the Redbirds. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive.
Looked like he was cheating a heater right there. A little bit too far out in front. Gotta find a way to keep his hands back.
But taken in over at first for the second out, as that might have been extra bases if it were 3 feet higher.
The first base.
So now into the box is Paul Goldschmidt. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. And this one misses here. Close pitch on 3-2, but Clyde Washington rules it ball 4.
No left fielder.
So the next to bat will be Tyler O'Neill, who went down on strikes in his last at bat. 3-1 to the Cardinals left fielder.
Well, this has been a long inning already, and I know he doesn't want it to get any longer. I expect a challenge pitch right here.
Swing and a miss, and the count goes full 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Myers is under it. And that retires the side. Begin the 8th, and next to bat will be the outfielder, Fernando Tatis Jr. And he takes a called strike 2.
Hey, I still believe in my heart the best pitch is a well-executed fastball down and away, and that's exactly what that is. He swings at that. That's off the end of the bat. That's not hard contact at all, and that's an easy out for the defense.
Ready with the 1-2. And it's 2 balls and 2 strikes now.
Boy, that's one of the toughest pitches to lay off. A hard breaking ball at the back foot. Tough take on a terrific pitch.
Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first down. So next to bat will be Manny Machado. 1-for-2 in the ball game thus far. On the fastball, and it's 1-2. And there's a fastball well off the plate inside.
2-2.
Well, 2 straight fastballs inside haven't put him away. So now it'll be interesting to see what he turns to.
And the slider gets him swinging. 2 gone. 2 out, nobody on.
Nope.
2 balls and a strike.
I'd be real surprised if he goes back out away there on the mound. This is a count for a fastball challenge, and we'll see if he's ready for it in the box.
Padres shortstop ahead with a 3-ball, 1-strike count. Liner in there for a base hit. So Will Myers will get a chance to bat this inning following the base hit.
The left fielder, number 5.
Into the box now, Will Myers. And he takes ball 2, and it's 2-1. Lifetime against Andrew Miller. He's 0-for-5. Chopped toward the second baseman. Fielded cleanly. Throw cleanly into first, and that ends the inning. Pierce Johnson. He's on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the 8th.
Number 36.
Bottom of the inning now. And standing in is the veteran third baseman, Nolan Arenado. Two balls and a strike to the St. Louis leadoff hitter. With this one almost in the books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Yeah, you ain't kidding, Matty. Dan. What does this feel like when balls are just flying out of the yard?
Hero, it's just one of those days when you're out there as a pitcher going, oh, I wish I was somewhere anywhere else but on that bump right now. This has the makings of being a long game.
So we got him swinging. Nolan Arenado becomes the first out in the bottom of the eighth inning. Two balls and a strike to Molina. Two and two to the Cardinals catcher.
That's the exact spot to lean on as a reliever. As a hitter, you just have to tip your cap and look for the next one.
And it's another K. So back-to-back strikeout victims to start this relief outing. Set and the 1-1 pitch.
Two and one.
Bases are empty here with two men out. And he fouls this one off. Here now, the 2-2.
Three ball.
And this is popped up near second base. Frazier is there, and he's got it for the final out of the frame. Genesis Cabrera is in out of the bullpen now as he'll be inserted into the number six spot following the double switch. Lars Nootbaar will also enter as a part of the double switch as he'll hit in the seven hole in the lineup. Look into Molina now, the one. Hit back up the middle, scooped up, and a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out. Next to bat will be Victor Caratini. The 3-1. On the ground for the shortstop, DeYoung. He's got it. Throw on to first, and the Padres are down to their final out now. And the hit will be Trent Grisham, and he needs to happen. They're down to their final out here in the ninth. San Diego down to strike, and it's fouled away. Now announced at a bit over 23,000 comes to their feet. Fouled away. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Hey, one of the keys to having a good record in baseball is to win some games at home. So this was a big win to win at home in front of their home crowd.
6-2 total today. The St. Louis Cardinals in the second inning and rode that till the very end. Adam Wainwright takes home the win. Yu Darvish was only able to work four innings as he takes the loss. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.